What if you could borrow money in seconds without ever stepping foot in a bank? This is the future of finance on Solana. Lending platforms are like permissionless banks. They're open to anyone with a wallet and powered by smart contracts written in code. You can earn yield on Sol, USDC, or other crypto assets you deposit, and easily take a loan if you need, using those deposits as collateral. Taking out a traditional bank loan can be a long and expensive process, while lending and borrowing with crypto is accessible, fair, fast, and transparent. Crypto lenders also offer better rates for both borrowers and lenders. That's why lending and borrowing has become one of the biggest sectors in DeFi today. Now, let's break down how Solana lending typically works. First, you'll need some crypto assets like Sol or USDC. After connecting your wallet to a lender like Kamino or MarginFi, you'll see all the assets they accept for lending and borrowing, and the estimated annual yields depositors are earning. Let's say you want to deposit USDC onto Kamino, treating it like a high-yield savings account. Select USDC, enter an amount to deposit, and confirm by approving a transaction from your wallet. You're now earning interest on your USDC. So, how are crypto lenders able to offer 10% or sometimes more on USDC deposits? Well, it's a handful of things, starting with DeFi having much less friction, overhead, or operating costs than found in TradFi, but it's also largely due to the supply and demand dynamics within the ecosystem. If thousands of users are depositing their Sol holdings as collateral and borrowing USDC to access more capital, Kamino's smart contracts will adjust interest rates automatically based on the real-time supply and demand. Demand for stablecoins typically increases when markets are trending upwards. In regards to lending platforms, this means higher yields for depositors and higher interest rates for those with outstanding loans. So, why would someone borrow USDC? Many crypto investors will hold Solana or Bitcoin as long-term investments, with no plans to sell it anytime soon. Without a lender, that capital is somewhat tied up in those investments. You can unlock some of that capital by depositing onto a lender like Kamino, where it's accepted as collateral that can be easily borrowed against without requiring you to sell. Sort of like taking a home equity loan, except the Bitcoin or Sol is in place of the house. The crypto industry moves fast. Active participants in the space will often be presented with new short-term investments and DeFi opportunities. Having the ability to quickly access capital through over-collateralized loans can be a useful tool for experienced investors and savvy DeFi participants. Remember, while lending on Solana offers exciting opportunities, it comes with risks. Before trying any lending platforms, make sure you understand things like loan-to-value ratios, how interest rates are calculated, and what it means for your tokens to be liquidated. Remember that crypto markets can be volatile, potentially leading to liquidations for those who mismanage risk. Always do your research and stay informed. Powered by StepFinance, SolanaFloor is Solana's number one news and education source. For more in-depth guides like this one, visit SolanaFloor. Learn.